Everyone, welcome to a very special Sunday live stream today. Excited to see everyone here on a Sunday. We have a special guest with us. We're going to bring him on in just a moment. And we have got a treat today. Jeff from Smart Pots is live at the Cultivate Garden Show. It's in Columbus, Ohio. It's a garden industry show, and they show a lot of plants, flowers, trees, even different fun gardening gadgets that are coming out for the garden.
Sunday live stream today. Excited to see everyone here on a Sunday. We have a special guest with us. We're going to bring him on in just a moment. And
okay, sorry about that, everybody. Jeff is going to be on and showing us around the Cultivate Garden Show. It's going to be a lot of fun. You're going to see some really cool, beautiful flowers. He gave us a little bit of a preview when we were just talking to him in the chat a moment ago. So this is going to be fun. Now, let's see if our chat is showing up. We are streaming. I think actually our ad is still on here at the
beginning. Yep, we're good.
Okay, there we go. Jerry, how do you make the chat show up here? I'm not sure.
I don't remember.
Okay, well, I'm going to actually look at the chat here on my iPad and see who all is here today. And Nisha, if you could let us know if the picture is clear, if you guys can hear us. Oh, there we go. All right, thanks, Jerry. Okay, it looks like we're showing up. Okay, great. Then we'll get going here in just a moment and bring Jeff on.
So this is kind of a first look what Jeff is giving us, right? He's kind of taking us inside, you know, to things that haven't even been released yet. Is that what I'm understanding?
Exactly.
And they're coming up soon. This is a real big treat. So thank you very much to Jeff with Smart Pots. This is going to be good. Want to bring him in?
Let's bring him in.
All right. Here's the moment of truth to see if everything works. Okay, 3, 2, 1, and Jeff, can you hear us?
Good afternoon.
And what? Shoot.
Okay.
Hello?
Okay.
Exactly.
All right, I'll be right back.
Okay, Jerry's going to get something because right now we're getting like double sound here. So Jeff will be able to hear. I don't know if everybody in the stream can hear you, but I can't hear you right now. So Jerry's going to fix that. But Nisha, if you could please let me know if everyone in the stream can hear Jeff or if it's just us, that would be great. And Jerry, good thing he's here today. Good thing it's a Sunday because he's working behind the scenes to try and get something so I can actually hear Jeff. So in the meantime, I'm going to say hello to people that are here in the chat. Tanya's Townhouse Garden. Okay, you can see us. That's great. Edward, welcome. Glad you're here harvesting a lot of things from the garden. And Terry can see and hear Jeff. We just can't. We're getting some kind of feedback. So great. Thank you for all of the information here. Jeff, you can go ahead and talk to our audience for just a few moments and tell us what Cultivate is all about while Jerry gets things set up here on our end.
Well, hey, everybody. Thanks for having me, Kim and Jerry. Cultivate is all about, it's basically a grower's show. It's in Columbus, Ohio, several hundred thousand square feet of the exhibition. And there is everything from plants to equipment that the nurseries use throughout their operations, especially the commercial side. What we're going to see today, a lot of this stuff plant-wise will not be available into your local nurseries for another couple years. So, you know, you're going to get a sneak peek at some different plants, different colors of things that are out now, different species. And it's pretty wild seeing some of this stuff and knowing that you're not going to see it out in the market for a while. And then some of the introductions here and the booths that they do, it's all living plants, stuff that is grown in greenhouses specifically for this show. So that it'll be in full bloom when it gets here. It's pretty spectacular to see everything that you're going to see. So we'll try to give you a sneak peek at a lot of different things and the different equipment and some of the processes. And again, this is all growers that actually develop these plants in their greenhouses using pollinators, grafting. You know, that's how it all is created. It's all scientific and all put together and comes together for this show and they introduce it. So
that is so cool. And we actually are good now. We had double sound for a while, but now we can, now everything's good. So great, Jeff. Thanks for being on today. Really appreciate you taking the time to show us around. And what is like, what do you want to show us first? It looks like it's a really huge convention center there.
It is. So let me give you some sneak peek to some new petunias.
Ooh, wow.
So check this out. It's a sunset orange. It's called Super Cal Premium. I thought that was beautiful.
Wow.
This one is called Bordeaux. Very rich colors.
Wow.
Then we've got the Yellow Sun, which is a mini petunia, kind of a miniature look. And this is one that I saw that I really liked because I am into succulents. But check out this sedum.
Oh my God.
This is called Chocolate Ball. Just that's gorgeous compared to this is your green and then the yellow, which, you know, a lot of us have seen.
Succulents are so big right now. And the nice thing is they take a lot of water. So it's good for people that live in drought areas like we do to grow them.
So sorry, I gave you a picture of the trash can there. That wasn't really
Is that a new one?
But yeah. But let me grab my Vanna White assistant here.
You got an assistant today, huh?
I've got an assistant. Yeah, we're going to walk down.
All right. Hi, Urban Chicken Mama.
This
Sally
is my assistant. Oh, there we go. He wants to be in the camera.
All right. Hello.
You know, he's... What's up, guys? Ladies, he's taken, so...
Is that Todd?
That's Todd.
Hey, Todd.
All right, Todd, nice to meet you. We've heard a lot of good things about you so far.
So here is, again, some different types. So petunias, that seems to be the big deal at this show this year, but the colors. So that's called Shortcake Blueberry. Isn't that gorgeous?
That is so pretty. That striping and that flower.
Sunhouse Potpourri.
Wow. How did they come up with the names?
I have no idea. This is Shortcake Raspberry.
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
So, Jeff, let me relay some of the comments to you here. Angela is saying, beautiful petunias. They should attract the bees and the butterflies.
They will.
Yep. Edward is saying, those flashy colors of petunias are so pretty. They're hypnotic for him. Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Beautiful petunias. And someone from Maryland said they need a show like this in Maryland. So can you work that out, please, Jeff?
I'll put the good word in for them that they need this show in Maryland.
Yeah, put that on Todd's plate.
Okay.
Todd, you got a job now. Like if you didn't have enough to do already, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So are a lot of these coming to garden centers like next spring? Or maybe explain that when we were...
You're probably going to see them within the next two springs. Look at this one, though. This is gorgeous.
Wow.
Purple Vein Smart Tunia, it's called.
Oh, my gosh. So those are perfect for hanging baskets. Those are so pretty.
Exactly. And the thing that, you know, people don't realize is a lot of these, and what I'm showing you here, like that Smart Tunia, they're being bred to last longer in the heat. Grow under more difficult conditions. So it's not just these colors that they're breeding into these plants. It's this ability to last longer, to, you know, petunias get leggy, it's to keep them bushy. So there's so much technology that is now going into plant growing. And this is a show that they show that at. And people just, you know, they don't realize how much goes into it. There's a lot of science that goes into this. It's not just planting a plant in some soil and being done.
Yeah, Jeff, Jay Harrison said that the orange sunset petunia, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So, yeah, it's trying to get over here to this other booth where we can look at some other...
With the weather changing so much everywhere, like everybody has been talking about how hot it is this summer. So things like that will really help make our lives as, you know, backyard gardeners a lot easier. So we're not.
Absolutely.
Oh, my gosh.
So isn't that beautiful, Rebecca?
Oh,
my gosh. That is incredible. Look at the color.
Yeah, it's just spectacular.
Wow. That is. Oh, and the daisies.
Yep. It's just everything. Different, different succulents that are coming out.
Wow, the succulent baskets are beautiful. Now,
and this Jamu just give you an idea of this booth. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's okay. Jamu was asking, where do we buy exotic dual tone petunia seeds? But these are more like plants that'll be coming
You're probably never going to be able to get the seeds for these because the seeds are generated. The patents are owned by the initial growers.
Okay.
And so what happens is, once they're growing, they're growing what they call starters, and they sell the starters to other growers that actually supply the nurseries. So you're not going to get seeds, and you're not going to be able to graft them or to generate a seed because they'll be sterile plants.
Okay.
They protect their patents pretty strongly in this industry. And if you violate that patent, I mean, it's a federal offense. So they're constantly watching each other, making sure that nobody's stealing their color. So when the patent's over in a few years, then it'll come to market and everybody will have it. But today, not going to happen.
Yeah, exactly.
I will say, just in the brief experience that I've had with you, Jeff, and also with Diane at the National Garden Bureau, it's a whole different circuit of what we're talking about here.
Mm-hmm.
It is, there's laws, there's legal things, there's experimenting, and yeah, it's a whole complicated system
mm-hmm.
that you would never know existed.
No, you have no idea. And like I said, what goes into growing these things and coming up with these specific varieties, it's amazing, and how they actually breed them and pollinate them and do it. So again, it's, a lot of these are done under real sterile conditions. Here's something that's kind of cool. This is a new, let me see what it is.
Oh my God.
Calentia.
Colors, just incredible.
Look at that. And just give you an example, this is like,
oh wow,
you can do a selfie here.
Fun. Valentine's Day.
Yep.
A little early.
A few more petunias.
Oh, gorgeous.
We don't ever do selfies.
No, never.
Yeah, I know.
Those would be pretty.
I've been with you, Jerry, I know.
We were just at a wedding last night in Malibu, and these flowers would be gorgeous, like in hanging baskets.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think, that's the thing too, that's a great point because people don't realize you can save a lot of money just doing some of this stuff on your own, versus hiring people. So let me show you, this is Ball Floral, and Ball is one of the biggest plant cultivators.
Yeah. Yes.
And they do it it's a huge booth.
They've
got a ton. Again, it's a lot of petunias. That must be the hot flower this year. This one's really pretty.
Oh my gosh.
Hey Jeff, we have a lot of people asking about heat tolerant. So if you see any mention of that, let us know. And we got a lot of people curious about heat tolerant plants.
Flowers. And the other question people are asking is, what does it mean when a plant is sterile?
It means that it's not going to shoot off seeds.
Okay.
So you're not going to have seeds that come off. So you're not going to have volunteers, basically.
Right.
Okay. Here's impatias. These are the double.
Oh, wow.
Those are burgundy. Gorgeous.
And those are shade tolerant, which is nice if
you
have a spot without too much sun and you want flowers there.
Absolutely. They've got some new varieties of coleus. And here's one that is just unbelievable.
Oh my gosh, look at those leaves.
That's called Microblaze Spitfire.
Huh. Wow. Beautiful. Man, it's just like a plant person's dream there.
Oh, it's crazy. And you can just walk for days the show is, you know, three days long, and there's growers that specialize in certain things. Like here's a Sumbeckia Luna.
Oh my god.
These are more Rudbeckia. Isn't that pretty?
That's beautiful. And SS is asking, where is this? It's in Columbus, Ohio, SS.
Columbus, Ohio.
Jeff Potts is in at the Cultivate Garden Show. It's a garden industry show.
And there,
great.
There's some
on here, maybe Karen.
Various colors of Rudbeckia.
Yep. Smart Spot. Smart Pot has joined the live stream as well. So feel free to fire any questions at them in the chat.
So Jeff,
gorgeous maybe, Japanese maple.
But
what was that called, Jeff?
That's a Japanese maple.
Oh, I love those trees. That is beautiful. The leaves are just incredible.
So yeah, we're gonna head to what this is more of a this section is what they call branded plants. So you've seen a lot of the stuff that shows up like in Sunset Garden Center or Sunset Magazine. A lot of the stuff is things that are really exclusive. So like right now, this is
Blight Fighter.
Better boxwood. And it's a boxwood that's blight resistant.
Nice. Wow, that's
so
funny.
This is called Babylon Beauty.
Those make like beautiful hedges, just beautiful.
Absolutely.
Plants.
We've all heard of, you know, Encore Azaleas. This is kind of some of the new colors and varieties, but I'll try to get in close enough. But that's an azalea.
Oh my gosh, that's beautiful. And a lot of people are saying thank you for the flower show. Angela's saying they couldn't get impatience in Maryland for a couple of years due to some kind of disease, but they're back now.
This is true. And
yeah.
The impatience that I just showed you are disease resistant. So
nice.
That's what you're seeing. You're starting to see a lot of the issues that came into the market with that. They're now correcting by genetically modifying the plants so that they're resistant to these diseases and these blights. And she's exactly right. Most of the country couldn't get impatiens because of that.
And that goes back to what we were saying earlier, that this is a science thing. So that means those scientists had to develop something to counter that disease. That's
absolutely
a lot of pressure.
Absolutely. Yeah, they do a lot of work, you know, to sit there and develop it and figure out what they can do genetically to those plants to correct those issues. So we're walking down to the other section to give you some more looks at different things. Let's walk this way.
Well, it's nice that it makes it easier for the backyard gardener because there's a lot of challenges with the weather, like I mentioned earlier. So all these issues, you know, come in and make it tough for people to grow flowers and vegetables and trees. So this will be really neat to see.
Absolutely.
These. Yeah.
So this is, again, like Ballport. This Syngenta is a huge, huge grower. And they grow a lot of different, real spectacular color. But, I mean, here we
go.
Some impatiens.
The colors are just stunning and the flowers are huge. The blossoms are huge.
Yep. And just, I mean, look at that orange.
Oh my gosh.
Unbelievable. And
wow.
To the red. The sunflowers. This is a 3 gallon right here sunflower. And look at the amount of blossoms on that thing. And these are the smaller, the dwarfs, so they're not going to get that big leggy.
That's perfect for patio sunflower.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Jeff, listen to this. Sharon is saying, what an amazing convention. Who would have thought that they have a convention for flowers and growers? This is amazing. So thank you very much for kicking us in.
Yeah, no, it is... surprisingly enough, you know, it's very kind of exclusive to people in the industry because I had a friend of mine who's in the industry, and he called today and said he wanted to get in, but the ticket was $400. So,
wow.
You know, they don't just let anybody and everybody in. You've got to be really an industry insider or part of a manufacturing. Here's, this is kind of cool. You want to see where the whole business has gone with automation.
Oh,
what?
Oh my gosh. Wow.
This is, you know, they're filling the containers with peat and they're putting the plugs in. So that's actually getting planted.
So when you see those little pots in the garden center where your transplants come in, this is one method of filling them and getting them to the market.
So they brought this in and set this up for this convention.
Yes. This is all set up for this convention for 3 days.
That's incredible.
And this is, you know, they're breaking up the peat.
There I am thinking they're transplanting their stuff just like I do, you know?
Yeah, we need to get one of those.
Yeah, we need one.
Kind of beats doing it all by hand, huh, Kim?
Yeah, sure does.
And then this is a little more of the nursery business meeting robotics.
Oh my gosh.
Kim, you definitely need one of those.
Yeah, we need a little spot in our garage for it, right? We might have to expand.
Okay, yeah, Todd's directing me over here, so we're going to go to, here's another really cool grower, commercial grower, Suntory. And they do, again, a lot of color.
Gosh.
Oh, beautiful. A million bells. Wow.
And just to kind of show you where the industry's going, they're cross-branding with Ordina drinks so that the color matches the drink flower. The color of the flower matches the drinks. This one, they've got a big Airstream trailer that is branded that's in here, which is
That's beautiful. Is that electric? Was that electric plug on that one?
Yes, it was.
That's neat.
Electricity.
But yeah,
I thought maybe it was electric vehicle or something.
Check out the colors on this.
Oh my gosh, wow, it's just brilliant. That's crazy.
Jeff, yeah. we have a viewer in Germany who says that you have so much more varieties in the US than we do, so many new ones each year. I'm thrilled and a little sad that I can't get them here in Europe.
Yes, and you know, that's check out that. I hadn't seen this one yet. Check that out.
Oh my goodness, that's
isn't that beautiful?
Serfina.
Thank you, by the
heavenly
way.
Heavenly amethyst burst. Yes, I mean, And that is true. We do have a lot of different varieties here, but you know, we've got the nice thing about the U.S. is that we've got so many different growing climates, and it allows us to have so many different varieties. And you know, again, I always tell people, keep in mind, we come to these shows and we see stuff in prime. And this is no lie. Yesterday afternoon, we went to the back of the convention center, and there's an area that's probably 5,000 square feet, and it's what they call the rejects, and it's plants that they've decided not to use in their booths, and they just put them back there, and they allow those of us that don't have, you know, flowers in our booth to go back and grab what we want to use them to decorate. And the rejects are very cool, but you know, Todd lives here, so you know he definitely grabbed a few that he'll be taking home with them.
Nice. The rejects are probably better than our best flowers.
Yeah.
Wow, that's neat.
That's pretty nice that they do that.
So hydrangeas. This is a new one. This is called Popstar.
Oh, look at that color. That's really unusual. Oh, wow. It's like a variegated.
Gorgeous.
Yes, beautiful. Oh man, I've never seen a hydrangea like that before. That's pretty.
And then let's see, this one's called Bloomstruck.
Wow.
It's beautiful. I believe this one is called Summer Crush.
Oh, look at those colors. That is just unbelievable. Absolutely beautiful.
And then we're going to walk back here because there's actually an area with real exclusive stuff that this is the stuff that legitimately probably won't be on the market for another 5 years because it's still in certain processes of patenting and
Wow.
the finalized stuff. But yeah, it's this thing is acres. I mean, we're only getting a tenth of what we really see. Oh, look at this Rose of Sharon. This is gorgeous.
Oh my gosh, look at that color. That's just crazy.
Wow. Isn't that awesome?
Yes.
I'm just drooling over all the colors. Just nuts.
Yeah. So this area right here is what they call new varieties. And these, like I said, legitimately are things that will not be seen for some time.
It's amazing how long it takes to develop all these and come to market.
Look at that one. This is full acacia. This is called Waikiki.
Oh,
isn't that gorgeous?
Beautiful.
Let's see what people are saying. Wow.
Someone is asking, Luz is saying, can Jeff show if they know what region zone you can grow these plants? Probably a variety.
Yeah, you know, a lot of them don't have labels on them that say, but like on this one, I mean, this is actually Holly, but that one's telling us regions.
Okay.
Some of them say it and some of them don't. So let me, and some of them don't have the tags that will tell me that. Check out this hydrangea, though.
Oh, that's a
hydrangea. Oh, my goodness. Look at those petals, green and pink. Bloom something. Yeah. Oh my gosh. That's crazy.
Isn't that beautiful?
That is incredible. I can't wait to see these in garden centers.
And then mums, whole different.
Oh, that color.
Oh,
I can't wait to get those. Those are beautiful. Artistic red, artistic almond.
Jeff, we have a viewer watching from Spain. Well, not Spain. Charlene, anyway, she's saying that these colors are simply amazing.
They're absolutely, and I just don't think what I'm showing you does them justice. They're beautiful. They're just gorgeous when you're walking by. This is a really pretty. This is a Sanguina mega purple vein petunia, and the flower on that is the size of. I mean, it's the size of a baseball. You can't really tell, but it's huge. It's a huge flower.
Crazy.
And then this is Sanguina coral.
Such a brilliant colors. The color is just so deep, you know?
And then this one is absolutely my favorite. This is called Funhouse Papaya.
What a great name.
I mean, it's yellow with kind of a pink tinge to it. Gorgeous.
Wow. Well, you can see why it takes them so long, because they've got to grow these and make sure they're the color that they're trying to produce, you know?
And the other thing is, too, that you need to make sure that during the season they don't revert back to whatever color that, you know, is there. So, again, it's just all science and technology that go into it. This is a real pretty lantana.
Oh, that's beautiful. Different colors on the same plant. Sharon says, everything is beautiful. I'd be walking and touching everything.
Yeah, and the nice thing is you can touch them, smell them. Yeah, I mean, nice. They're not, you know, you can obviously can't walk out with them, but
yeah.
there's some, Todd's kind of walking ahead, pointing me in the direction I need to go.
Well, Jeff, Charlene and Rachel asked if you and Todd could please start over and get one of each for them.
Absolutely.
That would be fun.
Here's a real pretty This is called Pineapple Sun.
Oh, that's pretty.
Wow. Isn't that gorgeous?
Looks like there's something different for everybody, like no matter where you live.
You can pretty much find, yeah. And most of this stuff is, you know, it's designed for, if it's an annual, it's designed for any climate, certain times of the year.
Yeah, exactly.
Here's a real different Rebecca. But look at that.
Oh, wow. My gosh, that's amazing.
That's incredible.
That's huge.
Isn't that gorgeous?
Yes. Lantana is in the pollinators. Yes, it does.
That's a canna that's called Golden Flame. And then this one I thought was very pretty. This is Bronze Peach.
Wow.
That's amazing.
My mom loved that color.
She did. Yeah. And it's so cool to see all the flowers because with the pollinators, you know, kind of declining over the past few years, like it's really important that we have flowers in our gardens for the pollinators. So it's great to see
You know, and that's the good thing about these. They're designed to draw those. And you know, let's all face it, you know, there's food issues in the world. It's not just here in our country. We need to get these pollinators so that we can all start growing our own food, and the pollinators are the key to making all that happen.
Definitely. It's very important.
Jeff, tell us a little bit about the next step. Nothing is being sold here right now. Everything is just being displayed. I imagine brochures are being handed out. What happens after that?
The growers that you're seeing, that I'm showing you these plants for, hang on, Jerry, I'm going to stop right here and just flip the camera so you can see this shelf of petunias.
Oh, my goodness.
That's Manhattan, or Mayan Sunset.
Oh, my gosh.
The colors
That's
are
Golden Harvest.
We need to change our channel.
This makes me excited to get more hanging baskets and plant more flowers. Those are so pretty.
I mean, it's just unbelievable. But the next step, Jerry, to answer your question, is what you're seeing here is our finished plants, and what these growers that are in this building are selling are what they call plugs. So a commercial nursery that supplies the garden centers that you and I go to is going to buy the plugs from these big growers, and they're going to then mass produce those plants under those licenses. So they get licensed to grow those plants and actually become a grower of that petunia or that rudbeckia or that grass. And then they're licensed, they can sell it to nurseries. So that's kind of the next step. So like I said, again, you know, you're going to see stuff here and it's in the mature stage, but there is no mature plants out there for sale. So they're still got to get the plugs done, get them to the nurseries, the production nurseries, and then they move on to the garden centers. So 2 to 5 years is really a realistic thing. This is a, you know, another like kind of take you into Christmas type thing. That's another thing that we have here is a lot of
Christmas in July. It's coming soon. Wow, that's gorgeous.
Hey, listen, for everybody that's watching right now, are you enjoying this? Are you learning a lot in this walkthrough that Jeff, Todd, and Smart Pots are doing right now? Will you let us know in the chat? Just give us a quick something so we know that you're enjoying this. I think Jeff would like to hear that as well. So fire that away here in the chat. We'll read them aloud as they come in.
And if they say they want to see more Todd, I'm eliminating them.
Poor Todd.
I know.
Hi, Todd.
There he is.
Oh, is he behind me trying to sneak in my camera time?
I was photobombing you a little bit there.
Little bit, huh?
But you all are at a lot of different garden shows, so it could be fun to do at some another point too. There's another show that you thought people would enjoy.
Absolutely, we can do it again. There's several, but the one that really like shows off things is this one. So let me show you.
Wow, oh my goodness.
A few more.
Wow.
is a beautiful pink petunia called Success Pink.
Unbelievable. So many shades. A lot of people saying they're loving it. It's beautiful. Thank you so much for doing it. Enjoyable. A lot of comments saying so much insight into the business.
Yep.
So yeah, viewers are really, really enjoying it.
That's great. Thank you all. Keep that feedback coming so we know you're digging this.
This is I have very a garden. Cool.
I really love this. Learning a lot as well. Oh, wow. Look at that shade.
Yeah, that's called a Supertunia persimmon. But yeah, it's just... it's amazing. I mean, we just, you know, you walk through it. Here is another petunia called a super petunia. And the super petunias are mini and they're mounding. So you can see how they're growing. I'm going to try to get...
it's like a mound.
You can see it's a mound. So it's perfect for a hanging basket or, you know, a pot on your patio. Because petunias can get leggy.
Yeah.
And these are all, again, genetically modified, so they don't do that.
Oh, those are just like a mass of color, you know.
Yeah.
It's mainly color, which is really nice.
808 Ladybug, once more, Calikim with Smart Pots. We've got a great season coming ahead. Just we stay do. Tuned. Stick around.
The yellow, yeah, it's bright. It's just crazy.
Here's some ficus that I know you in Southern California can grow outside in certain parts of the country.
My mom had those.
Those make great houseplants too.
This one's really cool. And I don't know if you can see the leaves if I get close up, but it's got like some really cool variations in the leaves.
We can see
them. Unbelievable.
So pretty. Oh, and that green is so bright.
Yes. That's called upside down key lime.
Wow. I love that shade of green. It's just brilliant.
And then there's this is upside down black coffee.
I love the names. It's crazy.
Yeah.
How people are so creative to come up with the names there.
That'd be fun to be in that meeting.
Portulacas, you know, those are real popular, especially in hot climates. So work really well. And that color is spectacular.
Oh, yes. They're beautiful.
And again, another coleus. That's a mini me called watermelon.
Oh, that's pretty. So for smart pots, are you there like showing some of your new products for people to like plant?
We are. We have a booth here, and we're actually featuring at the booth our new urban collection, which I know you've been pushing, and you know, just so you know, everybody knows we heard people saying we want a smaller scale. We understand there's a lot of apartment, you know, residents and townhomes and stuff that they can't put a big garden in. So we're scaling a lot of our popular items down, and we've come up with this urban collection. It's extremely cool. We're doing it in greens, the forest greens, and it's all smaller. Basically the mini compost sack, I think, is going to be incredible.
Yes. I'm looking forward to that. I think it's so much easier to come up with 50 gallons of material to fill a compost sack than 100 gallons. And I think a lot of people who grow in small spaces will really find composting simple with that.
Mm. Love that. Yeah.
Let me show you this. This is gorgeous. This is a aroid greenhouse. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but that's a living wall.
Oh, that's so beautiful. All the green. It's so therapeutic just to be around all the green color.
Yeah, it's just gorgeous.
Corporate offices are starting to incorporate green walls into their floors as well.
Absolutely. And I think it's awesome because you got that wall space. Why not do it? And the plants, what, you know, people don't always realize is are very cleansing for the air. Yeah, I'll check these out. I mean, these are just gorgeous, the colors. And
One viewer is Jay Harrison is saying, I appreciate the smaller size. I'm in a townhouse. So I think that's going to work out really well for people to have those options.
Yes, and we'll have those they'll be in garden centers. And I actually think you already have the little shorty on your website.
Yes, we have the little shorty.
Yeah. And we'll have the compost sacks done and ready in probably just a few months.
Nice.
So since we are, we are talking about edible, this is really pretty. This is a pepper, dragonfly pepper.
Oh my goodness. That is a pretty beautiful color.
This is very cool. This is an ice plant eggplant.
Wow.
Or icicle eggplant. Icicle? Sorry. Icicle eggplant.
I think I might have that one actually in my garden.
This is
All America Selections.
Sun torch tomato.
That looks yummy.
So those are cool.
Ramona's asking, what's in the urban collection?
The urban collection is going to start out with the little shorty, which is our 3-foot long bed. And it actually, we incorporated handles on it so that it is much more easy to move around. And then we'll have the mini compost sack. And that one is going to be just a scaled down version of the full size compost sack. But again, it'll have handles on it, make it a little easier to move around. Both of those are going to be in green with black handles.
That'll be sharp looking.
And then we're going to be doing some combination packages of some smaller scale pots, be the 15s down, and those will all be green with black handles as well. So, we're slowly adding things. We'll be adding our milk crate liners to the collection as well.
And the handles make it so convenient. Because, especially if you're on a patio, you want to move your plants like either into the sun or into the shade, or maybe you want to bring them inside at some point if it gets too hot.
Yeah.
And I found that ones with handles are just so convenient. I love those.
Yes.
Excited to see that.
I mean, we're open to suggestions. So, if any of your viewers or followers are kind of like trying to garden and they're stuck and they have an idea, tell them to, shoot an email to us, jeff@smartpots.com.
And that's one thing I love about you guys. You we've incorporated some suggestions from viewers and you actually end up implementing them. So
yeah, exactly. We want to do what people, want and need in the market. And really, you suggested the compost sack needed to be shrunk down a little bit. So, we did some experimenting with it and boom, there we are. So
it's great. Now we have had lots and lots of requests for red. Is that coming anytime in the future, do you think?
I'm working on it. I am working on it. I promise I will get I will get it going. It is being worked on.
And not just because it's my favorite color, but how about red? Is it coming for Christmas?
I'm back here in Ohio right now, and red seems to be the color because of Ohio State. So,
interesting.
So people definitely want us to do some red. So we'll come out with something, and I'm hoping within the next year. The thing is, and I know all your followers understand this, is, we're a pretty small company. We're not huge. We're about 150 people. We manufacture everything ourselves in Oklahoma City. We don't source anything out. All of the fabric is made in plants for us under our supervision. So everything we do, we're doing ourselves. We don't have somebody that's out there making red fabric for us. We're actually having to produce it and get it ready and bring it to market. And all of the designs are done by our team, Todd and Dustin, and our plant manager, Uni, works on stuff daily, packaging. There's just so many things that go into it. So it's not always just really super easy to just, you know, bring it out immediately to market. But I'm gonna
some time.
Flip. We came back. We're at our booth, and here's the urban raised bed, which has been really popular.
Yes, we love that one.
And then there's the mini compost sack.
Oh, there it is.
I love the green because it just blends in so nicely to the garden. That's really nice.
Yep. So that's going to be, I think that's going to be an extremely hot item.
Yes.
And I want to take you out and before, because I know we're running out of time, but I've got to show you this living wall out in the lobby.
Oh, cool. Living walls are amazing.
That's pretty spectacular. But again, like if anybody has ideas, and Red, I am listening to you. I know that was, we ran a little contest and that was the number one color that your your people came up with. And
a lot of people wondering.
We'll do it. We'll get there.
Jeff, something I think you need to hear. Charlene from Spain said, a company that listens to its consumers is top notch. That's quite a compliment.
Yes.
Yeah. Kudos to you. I appreciate that. And we do. You know, it's people.
Hey, John.
Sorry. I know a lot of people here. So
you're doing great.
I've had several people try to stop and talk to me. And Todd's like, he's talking to people. Go away.
You're not just talking to yourself walking around.
Yeah, exactly. So I want to show you this. This is a living wall with mosses and ferns that got created by a company called By Nature.
Oh my goodness.
Isn't that beautiful?
That's all plants?
Yeah, that's all plants.
Oh, that is just crazy.
And then this is their, what are you kind of their booth.
Is it possible to get closer to that living wall there? So we can see what the plants look like close up? That's just incredible.
I see a butterfly wing.
And the butterfly is made of mosses.
Oh my goodness, that is just amazing. I've never seen anything like that.
Yeah, it's pretty cool what they do here.
And, comment in the chat if you like the living wall. It's just incredible.
And like I said, they go on. Some of these places just go all out. There's hundreds of, probably millions of dollars in plant material in here.
That's
and they
incredible.
Do this, it takes weeks, or weeks, I'm sorry, days to kind of get this thing done, but kind of just can take a look at the, you know, the layouts that they do.
So creative too.
Yeah.
Just incredible.
It's spectacular. And then there's one more wall over here that's kind of rock and mosses. It's actually very cool.
Jeff, everybody loved the first wall. They are just going nuts over it.
So many people commenting how much it's incredible, beautiful. Wow. Oh my goodness.
And this is a company called Planthropy, and it's in headquarters. I don't know if I pronounced that right. Plant therapy, I'll bet. It's headquartered in Columbus, Ohio.
That is an incredible. Luz says amazing design on that living wall. That's just crazy.
Yeah, it's just, you know, and then just give you an idea of, you know, this is the lobby that we're in right now. So, wow. I mean, you can see how big it is. So, yeah, it's spectacular. And
plants everywhere. That's just amazing.
I'm excited we were able to get to show it to your followers and that they could kind of see a part of the world that we see on a regular basis.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, thank you so much, Jeff. It was really fun to have a behind-the-scenes glimpse of this. It's something we would never be able to see, and our viewers wouldn't be able to see, the people that can't travel or whatever. So we really appreciate you taking the time. I know you're busy there at the show.
Yeah, again, you know, if anybody has ideas or thoughts, remember, we do custom stuff too. But if you think that there's something that we need to do, jeff@smartpots.com, or they can email you and you can get a hold of me.
Definitely. We'll pass on any feedback we get.
Yeah, and we'll work on it. If it's doable, we'll do it. So.
Well, thank you so much. It's been a real pleasure to have you on, and enjoy the rest of the show.
I will. It's day one, so we got two more days to go.
You got a big few days ahead of you. So hopefully have some fun, rest, and enjoy the colors there.
Tell Todd, thanks for being your handler.
I will. Definitely. I will. I'll let him know.
All right.
All right. Thank you.
We'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
That was incredible.
Oh, wait a second. Did we actually listen?
I don't know if we're on or not anymore.
I think we're still on, but I think our camera is hidden, so I don't know if you guys can see us, but thank you so much for joining us. We're going to go ahead and sign off for today. You can see a lot of people in the chat there, but this was a real treat. And don't forget, we are streaming tomorrow, our regular Monday live stream. And tomorrow we're talking about container gardening. So how to keep your container gardening. Oh, whoops. So anyway, guys, we'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
I don't know what if we're on or not. Nope.
You can see us, but can't hear us.
Oh, no.
All right. See you tomorrow, guys. Bye.
I hope we are.
Mm-hmm. Yes.